Mother Nature can be downright cruel and nasty. And that doesn't mean just from a snow perspective or cold weather perspective. It can also be too much rain, not enough rain. She doesn't really care, you know, in a manner of speaking, about some of the wildlife that affects, and it really affects white-tailed deer. I know that I've talked to some biologists, wildlife biologists, have said even in what they consider perfect environments for deer, they can't get all the nutrition that they need just from the foods that are available to them, the natural foods. And by that, I mean even crops like corn, soybeans, and alfalfa. So anytime you can supplemental feed, especially supplemental feed something with proper mineral content, you're gonna give those deer in those areas that little extra boost to promote healthier bodies and, in the long run, probably larger racks. The supplemental feeding that I do, especially in December and early January, it can be downright absolutely physically demanding. There are times that I look at the thermometer in the morning, mid-morning, when I like to go out and feed, and it'll be 15 to 20 degrees below zero. I just have to go out in it a little while. And I think about the deer that are living out in that weather and how beneficial it is to them to be supplemental feeding them. So the little bit of hardship that I have to go through, and it does add up after, you know, a month, is nothing compared to what they're going through and the benefits they're gonna get from this supplemental feeding.